In Ghana, the NPP, everybody knows, really, we know the mentality is totally different from these people use these stuffs. And Africa, we don't have ours.
Hello, welcome to my channel once again. Today, I'm here to share with you some of the things that I think African Americans and basically blacks from the diaspora can do to help Africa stand on its feet or be self-independent. These are some five things that I've listed that I know for sure if we get the help of African Americans and black celebrities and basically blacks who have money, trust me, these things can be achieved and Africa can stand on its own or stand on its feet. So let's go into the video. Please like the video and comment whatever you want to comment or share. Thank you. So number one, we have some Africans who have actually come up with certain technologies that's the only thing they need right now is finance. People who can finance, help finance their project or their product or that technology that they've come up with so that they can easily be able to mass produce all these technologies. I remember there is a guy, I think from Uganda or Kenya or something, I think he's from East Africa. This man has been able to produce a car which doesn't need fuel. He has been able to do a lot of things that does not even need. And this man, I learned, has had several attempts on his life. People just want to assassinate him because that technology that he is bringing, if he's able to bring these technologies into life or be able to mass produce it and do it well, I'm telling you, even the phone that you and I use, we are not going to buy any credit. These are some of the things that people have done that people don't want because they don't have the finance, they don't have the support. They are just stuck at one place. There is a Ghanaian too that has been able to come up with an airport that can translate whatever the other person is saying into the language that you will understand. So for instance, if the person that you are speaking with speaks, let's say, Chinese, and the person is talking to you, you can set it in a way that that Chinese language will be translated into, for instance, English, so that you can easily communicate with the person. And this man has been able to do this, but nobody is talking about it. I will try and put the link of that particular site where you can get this in the description so you can check it out. So there are so many things that Africans have done that they need. The only thing they need is financial support. So imagine if these black celebrities that we have, the footballers, the actors, the actresses, come together with their support, that they want to support these Africans. I'm telling you, do you think Africa will remain the same? Definitely Africa is going to move forward. These are the kinds of support that we need as Africans. We should come together and do this for ourselves. My second point is, you know, in Africa, our politicians, all they think about is numbers. And politicians in general, all they think about is numbers. Because they know that when they vote and they win. So what actually happens is that in every African country that for me, I know, it's more like a two-party state. And in Ghana, for instance, you have NDC and the MPP, you see, and all the time, if it is not NDC, it is MPP. And the people in the country, for instance, in Ghana, the NPP
everybody knows, it's public knowledge, everybody knows that it's for the Ashanti tribe, or the Ashanti region is their stronghold. And when it comes to the NDC, the northern region and the Volta region is their stronghold, or the three northern regions and the Volta region is their stronghold. And this is public knowledge and everybody knows. You understand? We vote based on tribe. We vote based on tribe. So for me, my solution is that the more African Americans that we get in Africa, for instance, in Ghana, the president has been giving citizenships to African Americans. Every year we see it, we see it. So imagine if we have about 1 million or 2 million African Americans who are citizens in Ghana, for instance, and these people or these Africans decide that we know the mentality of African Americans and blacks from the diaspora, basically. We know the mentality is totally different from Africans in Africa. Africans from the diaspora don't think about tribe, but they think about development and things that will help the continent. So for instance, if these Africans or African Americans or Africans from the diaspora who have become citizens in a particular African country decide that, okay, now we are citizens, we can vote. So we are coming together with a particular agenda that perhaps we want this for the from the government. So if we're a political party and you want to come, or you can do this thing for us, then we are going to fully support you with our vote. I'm telling you, I know you guys, you can easily do it more than we the Africans, but because Africans, we vote based on tribe. I want an Ashanti man to be the president. I want an Ever man to be the president, to be the minister, to be the MP. All these things. These are the things that happen in Africa. It's sad, but this is the reality. This is the reality. My third point is going to be, I think it's about time Africans and African Americans and Africans from the diaspora, basically, come together to develop a satellite for Africa. At this whole African continent, this huge African continent doesn't have its own satellite. It's sad. Because so many things that is going on when it comes to social media, telecommunication stuffs, these people use these stuffs, and Africa, we don't have ours. America has multiple, China has it, Russia has it. Why is it that Africa, we don't have it? Why is it that we don't have a satellite in space? Why? And it's not like we cannot do it. We can do it if we have the right funding. Trust me, we can do it, and we can also have our own satellite in space. This is one thing that I have been talking about for a very long time. We need our own satellite. This whole African continent, we need our own satellite. And definitely, you know, there are rich people in Africa and there are rich people outside Africa, or black people, black rich folks outside Africa. Why don't we come together and do this for the motherland? Why don't we come together and do this for the motherland? We should think about it and we should do something about this. My fourth point is going to be, a lot of the times you see African governments from different African countries go to the IMF, go to the World Bank, go to these international bodies for loans to finance projects in Africa. My question is, can't the Africans in the diaspora come together and decide that this particular country or this place, they need a rail line, they need roads, they need this, they need that. So we are coming together, because honestly, we have a lot of black folks outside the African continent, who are rich. We have the footballers, we have the actors and actresses, we have the a lot of them. These guys, the question is, can't they come together and say, and I will be so happy that a rail line, let's say from in Ghana, for instance, let's say from Accra to Kumasi, was being constructed by some African celebrities who came together and constructed these. And we have a lot of agreements that you can go into with the government. We have a lot of agreements. We have the PPP, that's the public-private partnership with the government. You can do a lot. You can go into a lot of agreements with these governments, so that I will be so happy that a Didier Drogba, a Chris Brown, a Beyonce, a Jay-Z, and some other footballers, Mane, all these guys came together and funded this particular project, and every money that is being derived from this particular project, it is going directly into these guys' pockets or into their account. I will be so happy to see something like this. I will be so happy to see something like this. And I'm hoping and praying that one day, these things that I'm saying will definitely come to pass. Because why should we be going for loans from international bodies and they will give us so much stress with huge, interest rate, like, and these African countries cannot pay. I will be so happy if my country, we owe someone like Beyonce, we owe someone like Jay-Z, we owe someone like Akon, we owe someone like the footballers that we know, the musicians, the athletes, all these guys. I would be so happy to owe these guys rather than owing these international bodies, so that they will be coming up with ridiculous laws for you to, like, things that it doesn't even go with your culture, and they are forcing it on you. I will be so happy to see something like that in Africa. And my last point, that's my fifth point, is we see African governments, a lot of them, who have actually gone in for loans, and it's difficult for them to pay off these loans. It's very difficult for them to pay off these loans. Someone will say, hey, this $1 billion money that these governments owe these international bodies, do you think they can pay or they can do this? Listen, it shouldn't be just one person. It shouldn't be just two people. We can have about 10, 20 celebrities coming together to pay off some of these loans. Because let me tell you, some of these loans that the African government owe, some of these loans actually, if these African celebrities and rich business people come together to pay off some of these loans, it will be good for all of us. Because some of the loans that we owe, Ghana, for instance, I think recently this government, I heard, I don't know whether it is true, but I lent our cocoa, like every cocoa that we have in Ghana right now has been used as a collateral or something. So every money that we get from the cocoa, for instance, does not even, like, the government doesn't even get anything from it. It goes directly to the people that we owe. Our gold, our oil, like, we have a lot of loans that we have taken that these guys are just benefiting from these loans. They are just benefiting from these loans that they've given us. And they have taken our natural resources, and they are just benefiting even more than the loan that they gave us. So for me, let's say if a government is owing a particular international body, let's say $2 billion, $3 billion, and we have people who can come together and add like come up with some, I don't know, anything that we can do. And I'm very sure Africans, we can do it. Someone will say the money is too much, but hey, we have a lot of black wealthy people around the world. Coming together to pay off some of these loans, you are going to be in charge of this cocoa, the gold, the oil, and trust me, when something of that sort happens, I will be so happy. A black person being the one that my country owes than these international bodies. I will be so happy. I will be so much happy. So I'm just pleading and also letting people know that, hey, these are some of the things that you guys can do to help the African continent, and for so that the African continent can stand on its own and be self-independent. If you can do this, if we can do this, trust me, in the future, in the near future, Africa will become something that all of us will be so proud of. We will be so proud of. So please, if we can do this, let's do it now. I know that there are lots of African Americans who are coming here and opening up businesses and like setting up their business and all that. It's a good thing. Some of them are going into real estate and all that. But the question is it enough? Can this change Africa, like the kind of change that we want? Can these type of investments change Africa? We all know that no, it can't. So please, if we can do some of these things to help the continent, let's do it. I thank you so much for watching this video. If you watched from the start to this end, I thank you so much and God bless you. Please don't forget to like my video, comment, and subscribe. See you in the next video.